crazy now. Homeless people just steal from homeless people and then just the next morning just come up and clean. Like everything's around. Like, all right, though, maybe I can get some contributors and bring me some clothes, some food, some hygiene products, you know. Give me a room for the night so I don't have to sleep on the sidewalk. And yeah. I've helped so many people since I've been here and done nothing but take advantage of me. And I just, I don't know, I've almost given up on humanity.
So how long have you been homeless?
4 months.
4 months?
Never thought I would be, but came from New York for my sister's wedding, my niece's wedding, brought my twin brother back, and things just happened.
Drug of choice?
Nothing now. I've been clean 6 weeks, but it was crystal meth.
So how old are you?
I'm almost 15. My birthday's coming soon.
Almost 15. You have any kids?
Yeah, they're my daughter and my granddaughter's in New York.
I mean, what brought you to Indianapolis?
Oh, I came back from my niece's wedding. And I brought my twin brother back. He was in New York with me, and I brought him back. Wedding. Well, I call her my little sister. She's my niece. So, then just kind of got stuck. And I decided, well, I'm going to stay. I'm going to have my old friends, have some old boyfriends, get a job, get a house. And just things didn't work out like that. Everybody started stealing things. And then it's maybe the people where I was going. And I was with my brother, and he thought it was just tent people. And then I learned the tent way, the tent city way. And I like these people. They steal, they lie, they con, they'll smoke up your butt. They're kind of fish out of water, and it's
sad.
Wow, I'm very sad. But it's not turned me bitter, but I've learned a lot, but I just don't understand how people be like they are. And nobody helps. Like, I had a seizure on the sidewalk, passed out, I'm so hot. No one, for like an hour and a half, no one stopped. Not to give me water. When I asked for water, people said no. And it's giving up on humanity. And then, you know, God tells me you need to never give me more than I can handle, and I always give a way out. So then, my daughter got kidnapped.
You said your daughter what?
My daughter was kidnapped. Helpful and said mean things and
So what would you say your purpose is?
To help the world, figure things out, to tell the truth, to figure out the truth, to fix it, fix things.
So how are you going to start? I mean, I know...
I already have.
What was the first thing you just said?
The bridges. The bridges, were crumbling. The top bridges were the top ones and the bottom ones were crumbling. So crumbling. All over the city. I've been all over the city. Look. That was the something. The rhubarb is bad. They're giving us a bad rhubarb. All the bridges are crumbling. Now they're getting fixed.
You have an email or anything?
I don't have anything. They stole before my phone. They stole my tablet. They stole my purse. They stole all my clothes, my hygiene. I have nothing. This is what I own now. And I came with $40,000 worth of stuff. And I got this over that building. So I'm just hoping that maybe it's somebody that sees this to come through and help with some stuff. Help me with a job, maybe. Maybe get a car. Bicycle, a tent, blankets.
Anything.
Anything.
So if someone wanted to come find you.
South side of the Hardee's, off of Washington Street at 65 or 70 West.
Alright. Any last thing you want to say to the world?
Man, Vicky, if you're reading this, I love you. Damien, I love you. And I'll bring you home soon. And Dan, if it's my twin brother, if you're alive and you see this, come and find me. And thank you, Lord.